Today we read an alarming passage from the book of Isaiah, chapter 5. It says, "Woe to those who are wise in their own eyes and who are prudent in their own sights." In this life, we're walking the path towards sanctification. We're journeying to attain the pearl of great price. But we are warned in this journey not to trust in our own hearts, because our hearts are deceptive. As Jeremiah says, "The heart is deceitful above all things and is desperately wicked. Who can know it?" We are warned in this journey not to trust in our own hearts, because our hearts are naturally drawn to wickedness and sin. In the book of Proverbs, it says, "Pride goes before destruction, and a haughty spirit before the fall." If I trust in my own understanding and think of myself as wise and prudent, I fall, simply because I cannot discern the true motives in my own heart. St. James says, "Each one of us is tempted by their own desires and enticed." This verse clearly explains and tells us that the origin of temptation and sin is mainly in my own heart and is mainly the evil inside the fallen humanity. And the church, as a wise mother in the second week of temptation, tells us and warns us about the warfare of self-righteousness. To think of myself wise and prudent, and to think of myself capable to guide my own steps and paths. Let me tell you about a story of Abba Anthony. Once he was sitting in the wilderness, and all of a sudden he sees the demon or the devil walking with all kinds of traps and tricks with which he uses to make humanity fall in sin. So Abba Anthony, in desperation, looked up to heaven. He says, "Lord, who can flee and who can escape all these traps?" And all of a sudden he heard a voice from heaven saying, "The humble will escape. The humble, my beloved. Let us be humble. Let us trust and commit our lives into the hands of the omnipotent and omniscient God, who knows our heart, and he searches our hearts and depth, and knows how to guide us into the harbor of salvation. Let us, my beloved, commit not to lean on our own understanding, and commit our lives entirely into the hands of a capable God." I will leave you with the words of Saint Augustine that says, "This is the very perfection of man, to know his own imperfection." And glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.